don't miss next week's Perseid Meteor Shower.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm Marlene Hidalgo from Miami, Florida.
And I'm James Albury from Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas from Cincinnati, Ohio.
We're here to help you get the most out of watching the Perseid Meteor Shower next week.
Yes, indeed. Next Monday night, August 12th, from after midnight through dawn, Tuesday morning, the 13th, conditions will be ideal for observing the annual Perseid Meteor Shower, which is usually one of the best meteor showers of the year.
Now, by ideal conditions, we mean that this year there'll be no moonlight whatsoever to interfere with the shower, because whenever there's a bright moon in the sky, many of the meteors are hidden from view.
So if you follow a few simple rules for observing, you should see a very nice show. Let's show you.
Let's start by looking west about an hour after sunset, and we'll see a six-day-old crescent moon about 5 degrees below the ring planet Saturn. And off to the right of the moon, we can spot Spica, the brightest star in Virgo.
Then, well off to the right of Spica is the brilliant planet Venus.
Hey, come on, boys. Focus. We're supposed to be telling people how they can best see the Perseid meteor shower.
Well, the phase and position of the moon are important for watching the meteors.
Because since the moon will set shortly after sunset, it will be completely out of the way when the meteor shower does get started after midnight.
Simply go outside next Monday night after midnight through dawn Tuesday morning and look straight up. To see the most meteors, here's rule number one. Hope it's clear out, because if it's cloudy or raining, you won't see any meteors at all.
Rule number two, get as far away from city lights as possible. Because even though you may see a handful of the brightest meteors from city locations, the city lights, like moonlight, flood the sky with so much sky glow that nowadays, many of the meteors in a meteor shower are hidden from view.
Rule number three, observe while lying on the ground on a blanket or a lawn chair. In other words, keep looking up.
Rule number four, stay outside for at least a couple of hours, preferably after midnight, and have plenty of patience.
If you follow these rules, you can expect to see several meteors per hour, and maybe many more. Simply lay back and constantly scan the sky, and usually when you least expect it, a meteor or even two will zip across the sky.
Now, although some astronomy periodicals will tell you that you may see 60 meteors per hour, which would boil down to about one a minute, meteors really don't operate on a time schedule. You may see 10 of them in 2 minutes, and then have to wait for 20 minutes to see more. But that's the fun of it, because each meteor is a total surprise.
Now, although meteors look like and are often called shooting stars, nothing could be farther from the truth. You see, meteors are nothing more than tiny pieces of comet debris, comet litter which slam into the Earth's atmosphere at such high speeds, over 135,000 miles per hour, that friction with the Earth's atmosphere causes them to burn up, and makes the gases in the Earth's upper atmosphere which surround the speck glow as the speck plunges toward the Earth.
Now, although we can see a few meteors almost every night of the year, every so often, just like clockwork, our Earth slams right into great clouds of comet debris. And one of these clouds, left floating in space by a comet named Swift-Tuttle, lies directly in the path of our Earth's orbit.
And every year in early August, our Earth slams right into that cloud of comet litter. And when that happens, we say we're experiencing the Perseid meteor shower, so named because the meteors all look as if they're coming from the constellation Perseus.
So, get outside late next Monday evening and early Tuesday morning, and every time you see a meteor streak across the sky, remind yourself that you're actually seeing a tiny piece of comet plunging to its fiery death.
Which is one more good reason to
keep looking up.